to our opera scenes tonight, and especially welcome to these really contemporary opera scenes. The oldest one is 6 years old. This is the first time that Abigail and I have worked together, so we're certainly hoping it's not the last time, and that this can be the start of something, at least on an annual basis, that we're putting together the instrumentalists, the singers, and hopefully maybe even doing more full-scale operas in the future. Abigail had a little incident this week. In case you don't know, she didn't just break her leg, her foot, she broke it in 3 different places. And yet she still kept the show must go on mentality the whole time. There was never any thought or remark that we would not be doing this tonight. So we're very proud and happy to be presenting this to you. So please welcome our singers and enjoy the show.
As a Yakima Nation member in the 1840s and 1850s, Qualchan lived a normal life. He liked to talk and joke and laugh with his friends. He would tease his friends if they got spooked by a noise that turned out to be a harmless grouse. Qualchan liked to hunt in the beautiful mountains near what is now called Wenatchee, ride in the valley in what now became the Ellensburg area, swim in what is now Icicle Creek, and fish in the Columbia River, in what is now the Yakima and Wenatchee areas. He fell in love and wanted to get married and have children and grandchildren. Qualchan followed the rules, customs, and laws set by his elders and ancestors for generations. He was a person just like you and me. On September 24th, 1858, Qualchan entered a U.S. Army camp and used a white flag in hopes of negotiating the release of his father. He was immediately captured and executed. The following excerpts from Gary Edwards' opera, Qualchan, depict large moments from Qualchan's life, beginning with his first feelings of love for his wife, Wistox, and ending with his capture and death by the U.S. Army.
Thank you. Gifts of food and Thank you. it will.